is expected to outline a plan to cut foreign oil imports by a third over 10 years, with more domestic production, conservation, and a shift to biofuels and natural gas. But so far, the president's had a cursed hand with his energy plans, and not all of it is his fault. Last year, he wanted to open up new areas of the country for offshore oil drilling, and then BP's oil rig blew up in the Gulf of Mexico. This year, he wanted $36 billion for new nuclear plants, and then Japan's nuclear crisis hit. Then his plan to regulate greenhouse gas emissions failed in the Senate, and his energy czar is gone. So let's talk this over with Bill Nye, the science guy. Bill, as one expert told CNN, the president picked three losers from the get-go. What do you say?
Well, he was working with the hand he was dealt. If you're asking me, and I got the impression you were, I think the United States should pursue better solar panels and wind energy. And the big thing we need to figure out is how to store and especially distribute all this energy. We have five times the energy we need in wind if we could store it and move it around. Just think about your own experience. Here's a modern flashlight. Runs on light-emitting diodes. Here's an old-style flashlight that you would crank with your hand. This uses a tenth as much energy as this. This is a result of science. This is a result of investing in research.
That is beautiful. But we had a big fight in the political arena in this country about the changing of energy-efficient light bulbs, like getting rid of the old light bulbs and going to more efficient ones.
I think that was based on scientific illiteracy, that banning the specific style of light bulb is not the issue. It's getting the light bulbs to be more efficient. And you can do that with tiered energy pricing with regard to electricity. Now, as far as the nuclear industry goes, in my opinion, they've gotten away with a lot for many years. They've cut a lot of corners, and it's not just true in the United States. It happened in Japan. So I'll make you a deal. We'll have nuclear energy if you can figure out what to do with the waste. I mean, really figure out what to do with the waste.
Because you're of the opinion that we should like call a temporary halt to the building of new nuclear facilities until we have these things worked out.
Well, yeah. I mean, but that's important, but a small part of the problem. I mean, to me, we need to invest in much more efficient solar panels. And this is physics. This is basic research. And so to my little business, you know, when you cut funding, for example, to the space program, you cut funding to research. And this is what's going to keep the United States from being a world leader in energy. Now, nuclear power, I hope it's one day like 8-track tape, you know, where, it was good. I mean, I enjoyed my 8-track tape, but I really, if given the choice, I wouldn't use it.
Well, see, it's interesting that you say cut funds to NASA, because the president was certainly in favor of that, right? At least cutting the part of the exploration of space. So,
well, the word exploration has been used to mean the space shuttle. And to me, the space shuttle, you know, if you had a globe, a 12-inch school globe, the space shuttle or the International Space Station is 5/16 of an inch above it. It's not like you're exploring these new places. You're just going to places people have already been for 60 years.
What about those valuable experiments they perform on the International Space Station?
Well, they're good. I mean, in the same way we maintain a presence in Antarctica. We always have a science base in Antarctica. In that same way, we will always want to have a science base in low Earth orbit. I mean, that's great. But it's not the same as going to someplace new.
Right. So, okay.
I stumped you. I'm sorry. We're talking about energy.
Because this is what I really want to ask you.
New energy.
I know, we need alternative energy. But the only time that Americans react and try to save energy, the only times our politicians react and try to change the way we use energy and the kinds of energy we use is when gas prices go up to $5 a gallon. When gas prices go down, we go back to normal. How do you fix that?
Well, bear in mind that in other countries, gas prices are way above $5 a gallon, way above that. Norway, Japan, most of Europe, it's way above $5 a gallon. But people still drive; they just don't drive as inefficient vehicles. Mm-hmm. You know, and the longest journey starts with but a single step. Electric cars, just in this one example, electric cars are much more efficient than heat-driven, gas-powered cars. Right. But these are all things we could be working on, but we need to invest in basic research. And this is easy for the guy sitting here to say, but I'm really serious, congressmen, senators. If you want the United States to stay ahead and change the world and be independent of the stuff going on in the Middle East and this misery that's going on the east coast of Japan, we need to get down to fundamental research. My watch is solar powered. It's about 10% efficient. What if it were 50% efficient? It would change the world, right?
Okay. Well,
so
we'll
this
see.
Is all science.
It's all science. Science is good. We'll see what President Obama has to say a little later. Thanks so much, Bill Nye, the science guy.
Thank